Hey guys, guess what? It's Friday, Friday, Friday. I'm just kidding. Sorry. I've been wanting to use that for a video since last week. So. And speaking of last week, I wanted to apologize for not having a video next week. Last week, no excuse. I woke up completely planning on making a video and then just never made it. And no excuse for me. So if you guys want to leave like a punishment for me to do, because I was capable of making a video, I just didn't do it. So if you want to, punish me for not having a video last week, let me know what I can do in the comments down below, and I will do them. As long as they're not too extreme, keep that in mind. Anyway, the first thing I wanted to talk about was the fact that Ringo's home is going to be demolished. It was announced, I think, today that despite the efforts of the Save Mandarin Street campaign, which I will link you to their Facebook page, I don't know if they're still going to try to do stuff. They might, I don't know. I will link you down below in the doobly-doo. And but anyway, yeah, the Ringo's home is going to be demolished. The local authorities gave the final order. So, yeah. If you have not been to Ringo's home place and you're in the area, I would definitely go to it. He was born at 9 Mandarin Street, so. Yeah, and I feel kind of really bad for the fact that it's going to be demolished. I feel like Ringo gets the short end of the stick a lot of the time, and I feel like if this was like Paul and John's homes, perfectly kept up, people can tour their homes. It's I think I can't remember. I think the National Trust maybe. I don't know. I don't. But some order is in charge of these homes, and people can go and see it. And I feel, and I know Ringo's home is in a worst off neighborhood, but I feel like they could fix it up and give it more a proper care, just like they would have done to John and Paul. Hell, they could do that with George's place, but I think somebody lives there. But 9 Mansion Street, I mean, they could fix that up. They can have tours going through there. I mean, I'm sure in the long run, the tourists visiting Ringo's old childhood home would outweigh, would they would end up making money eventually, I feel. So I just feel like I just feel like Ringo gets the short end of the stick a lot of the time, and this is just another example of the fact that they're gonna demolish his childhood home, even though he lived there for like, I don't know, like 5 years of his life, the first 5 years I read somewhere. So yeah, I will link you to the article and the Facebook campaign to Save Mandarin Street. I don't know. They might be still be doing stuff, I don't know. Okay, next topic I just wanted to answer some questions this time around. Speaking of Ringo, the JDC 34 Life asked us if what is our favorite commercial and/or TV project that Ringo has done, and if so, why? I really like that Pizza Hut commercial that he did with the monkeys. That was amusing. And he also did like some commercial for apple juice in Japan, because Ringo means apple in Japanese, so he did a commercial for them. I like that one too. Yeah, those are my answers. Crazy Girl 8343 asked, if Paul died right now, how would you react? Saddened, crying, shocked, not know what to do with all these emotions that would be flowing through me, like it would be horrible. I don't even want to think about that, and it's gonna happen because everybody dies, but it's don't even want to think about that. God, kind of a depressing question, crazy girl. I some Amy Grace 1234 asked if you could play a Beatles song on an instrument, or if you don't own a guitar, piano, or whatever, you could hum a song and then we could guess what that song is. I actually can play the clarinet. I've not played it for you guys. In fact, I haven't played the clarinet in a few years, so I don't know, it could be completely horrible, but I was good at one point. If somebody can find me clarinet pieces, you may persuade me to play it for you. A Beatles song for you. If I were a Beatle, who would I be? George. It's my favorite, you guys. I'm telling you for a reason. Okay. Lonely Hearts Club Band asked us to draw our favorite Beatle, but we had to be blindfolded. I didn't do it on Microsoft Paint. I drew it on a paper and pen, but it's pretty humorous. I drew George, like when George had the Jesus hair, you know, the long hair and the mustache. And I feel like this could actually be this is my drawing, first of all. Clearly, my eyes are closed and I was not able to connect the drawings. Like, that's his face, but then, like, that's his hair and mustache. So, I don't know. Maybe it's like some Picasso kind of thing, you guys. So, that's George with his holding his guitar. Isn't it awful? I am not an artist. Just embarrass myself on YouTube. But I hope I made you laugh. What is the most expensive Beatle item you own? Also by Amy Grace, 1234. It's either my Beatle Stereo Remasters box set. Because boy, did that cost a whole lot of money. Well worth it though. Or if we're going for like, sentimental, not sentimental value, but like, yeah, I guess sentimental value. I do owned. I can never speak. I apologize. I do own Sgt. Pepper's Lonely Hearts Club Band album from the 60s. I have two. One of them is completely like taped and written on in pen, but the other is pretty good condition. It still has the pullouts and stuff for it, so that one or the Beatles Remasters on stereo. And this question about, do we have any information on Ringo's legal filing to have his name appear first when naming the four Beatles, and that apparently he won that case? I've never heard of that before in my life. If any of you, if the original person can link me to the article or wherever you found that, I've never heard of that before. I've never heard of that. And I would like to know more about that because this is new Beatle information. There's another question by the same person who asked the previous question. How do you see yourself changing as a channel and a group from back when you started the Fat Fans to presently the Beatle Scruffs? We've gotten a whole new groups of people. I think the people that we have now, not to diss the people we've had in the past, because they've all been lovely. Everyone has been lovely who's been a part of this channel, but the people we have now are just, we're a lot different from each other. So I feel like it gives us a lot more of a variety, like, you know, so we don't bore you guys by our ramblings. I feel like we're a lot more looser. Like in the past, especially on the Fat Fans, we were a bit more structured. We did have themed challenges, which I would like to bring back, though I suck at coming up with challenges. But we were a lot more by the book, you know what I mean? And I feel like now we're more spontaneous and easygoing than we were when we were the Fat Fans. But I think we've improved as a channel. From the Fat Fans to the Beatle Scruffs to now, and it's amazing. Okay, I'm gonna go because this video is long and my camera stopped in the middle of the previous question. So, see you guys next Friday. Bye.